1,300 square foot lot. The footprint's about 230 square feet. It grew to three floors. Where it started off as like one plus a loft. So that's three floors now. And I'll save some of the other slides for more in depth talking about the project.
Hi, I'm Sarah Kleiner. I have co-founded Envisage Architecture and Roost Builders. Roost Builders came along after my construction partner, Bill Groth, and I went to Unibuilt Industries and saw what they were doing with modular housing and were just blown away. So, one of the first things that I get when I talk about modular housing is the difference between mobile homes and modular homes. They're often confused. So I've got four examples of other projects that the company has done. You can see a typical suburban home, which is really, that's really their bailiwick, but they've done floating homes. This is in Evanston, this is apartments and condos, and then condos then in Dayton down on the right. So there's they create boxes inside of a factory that are up to 16 feet wide and 60 feet long, completely finished on the inside. And you can stack those up to four stories tall, and of course you can go as long and as wide as your codes allow. So here you see the walls being built on a jig. Everything is perfectly square. The drywall is laid down first, and then the studs are put down on top of that. They're adhered with foam adhesive. So the drywall is completely flat. It doesn't take on any of the curves of the studs. And then you can see the floor is built in the same way. They're putting the floors and the walls together. Here you can see the roof is actually in transit. They put the roof on that platform and built it there. The roof is actually folded down, put on top of a box, and then put in place in the field. And I'll show you that later. This is an internal picture being moved on top of the box. On your left, you can see the foam adhesive. The other benefit of that is it cuts down on air infiltration. So you've got a tighter building, lower energy costs. On the right, you can see where they put the roof on top of one of the boxes, but you can also see they have a product they use called Tallwall, which means their sheathing is top to bottom, so you only have vertical seams. And again, with the adhesive, you get no air infiltration. There's no horizontal seams letting air through. So they come with windows, cabinets, plumbing, electric, HVAC already installed. So the big difference between a mobile home and a modular home is placed on a foundation, but it's built the same way, stick built, similar to stick built. A mobile home is actually built on steel and has axles and wheels, and it itself is the vehicle that travels down the road. So this is an installation at Morgan and Copeland in Walnut Hills. This is actually something that the county port authority did. On the left, you see the unit being taken off of the truck and put into place. On the right, you can see they just used crowbars to get it down onto the foundation. The lower right, you can see there's a sill plate and there's some straps. It's really put on just the same way a house is, just kind of in different order. On the left, the crane, they're using the crane to pull that roof up, and then they put it in place, and then the crane takes the unit, the box unit, with the roof in place and places it on the lower one on the right. And it's done in a day. So the exciting part is they can build these inside the factory in 3 weeks, and they can place it in a day. It was about a year ago, it was late November, but they did get it done and weatherproofed in a day. So the entire house is about 85% finished at that point. And then on the inside, the cabinets are in. You can see microwave, dishwasher, electric, lights, plumbing. The floors are in, craft papers over them to protect them while the house is being finished. Granite countertops. On the far left, that's where two boxes come together, so you can see the seam where the floor and the walls meet, so that'll be covered up with trim. That's a set of stairs in place in the center, and then at the top of the stairs, you see the two vertical where the pieces, the boxes come together. And there's some temporary wood in there just to keep it in place as it's being transported. That'll come out and finish the drywall. And then the other thing that we are looking at using in conjunction with Superior Unibuilt is superior foundations, and these are precast foundations that are built again in a factory, shipped on site. They're craned into place. In the far left, you can see the crane bringing one of the concrete sections through. A lot fewer slides, I think. I think I'm unclear on what I'm supposed to cover now versus later.
I think the goal was just to give a teaser when the premise is, so that we all understand.
Sure.
Like, let people know who you are.
Okay.
And what
well,
you
I'll skip the slides for now then,
yeah,
and I'll just tell. I'm Yvonne Morales, and I'm an architect. I work primarily in residential. When Judith first called me, I said, I'm not sure I'm qualified to talk about this subject. I think many of the homes I work on are at the other end of the affordability spectrum. They're in the millions of dollars, and that is what I do all the time. But I did build my own house, and cost was definitely a concern, and and dealt with that myself, and figuring out how to build what we wanted to build, how to have the design we wanted to have, and have energy efficiency and at a price we could afford. And I definitely see a lot of possibilities in factory building or just new technologies or new ways of delivering projects, but I think we probably went old school. We took the approach of building many parts rather conventionally and hiring conventional contractors to basically just build us a shell, and then just took on a lot of the rest ourselves. And you can, with the internet, look up how to install tile, how to finish your own drywall, how to make some things out of wood. Actually, we ended up taking down some of the trees on the lot and did a lot of the millwork, and did it by hand, did it over a long period of time, moved into the house when it was just passing occupancy standards, and then took at least 5 more years, involving family and friends and trial and error and a lot of just of our own work and sweat
That's a great model, right there.
It's a different model, yeah. It's just pouring a lot more and then going hand in hand with that, they're like involving our son in the construction and just really hoping for the next generation that that we all still know how to do things, how to make things, and that we don't divorce ourselves completely from that and think that we have to hire somebody to do everything for us.
Yeah, the skills,
right? Skills. And just belief that you're capable, you can do it.
Okay, so close your eyes for 30 seconds while I go through all these. Right, Edward?
Yeah, that's me. I have 3 slides, so it's hard to kind of...
Don't touch them.
I need to tell you a little bit about it. So we'll just stick with this one if we're doing it in pieces here. This is a delightful project that I got a chance to work on with my client Sandy Hamilton in Northside. I have my own small practice. We do all kinds of things, from small buildings to big ones. And this one has a really sweet story. It was for her mom to age in place. So she was living down the street in a home that she lived in for a number of years, and was getting to that point where it was just necessary to offer her more daily care. So Sandy said, I want to add on to this, to my home, but I don't want to change it. It's a grand home there on Hamilton Avenue. You may have seen it at the corner of Westmoreland and Hamilton. It has it could have easily fit a little apartment in there. But then we'd still have to work with stairs every day. And that was a challenge that Sandy didn't want to have her mom go through. So to the side, in the side yard here, where you see the word addition, we simply put a small structure. It's a freestanding structure, but yet it touches the home ultimately with a trellis, so that we are compliant with the zoning rules and considered an addition versus a freestanding independent dwelling unit. And I think the architectural nature of this project and the idea of independence and matched up with the idea of an independent home. And it's simply built construction. It has block foundation. It's got 2x6 walls. But we did some things just where they were a little more generous. You know, the windows are a little higher and taller. The doors are a little higher. The space is 16 feet inside. So there's some generosity in this small space. There's window access to the front and the rear so that you feel like you're part of things and not just tucked in the back or the side. And so that's the diagram. Accessible living, aging in place.